In today's episode, we are visiting the Ordensburg Vogelsang in Germany. This video might be a little bit different from other ones because the castle isn't exactly abandoned, but still a very interesting place with a lot of history. The site of the castle is with an area of 1 square kilometer and a floor space of over 50,000 square meters, one of the largest remnants of Nazi Germany. But let's start at the beginning. In 1933, Hitler demanded the construction of places where future leaders of the Nazi Party should be educated. They planned the construction of 3 so-called Ordensburgen, which means castles of the order. This one is called Vogelsang and is located in central West Germany, close to the border to Belgium. Construction started on a lonely mountaintop in 1934 and was finished in only 2 years. Each castle had a key subject in its education, and Vogelsang's was the racial philosophy of the new order, which is exactly as terrifying as it sounds. The mostly young men were indoctrinated with aggressive political and racist theories. In addition to the castle itself, which included lecture rooms, a pub and everything, there were a lot of different buildings in the complex. There are 14 houses for accommodation, a sports field with a gym and swimming pool, an airfield, a tower and more. Remarkable is also the art, for example this so-called sportsman relief, made from lava rocks. And yes, those holes are bullet holes. With the breakout of World War II in 1939, the castle stopped its educational program and became a station for troops of the Wehrmacht, the Nazis' armed forces. During the war, a few buildings were also damaged by airstrikes, but it was never destroyed. After the war, in 1946, the British troops occupying the area considered demolishing the place due to its strong Nazi symbolism, but they decided to establish a military training area on a large piece of land surrounding the castle. This area, including the castle, was then given to the Belgian military in 1950, who stayed there for many years.
Water system here.
On the foundation of buildings, which were planned in the Nazi era but never finished, they constructed new and additional buildings. What you can see here is an accommodation building for soldiers, which was supposed to become a library of the Nazis. They even built a cinema on the foundations of a never finished auditorium, and also rebuilt everything which has been destroyed in the war. The military usage ended in 2005, and since 2006, the whole area is open to public. By now, the place features a permanent exhibition and an international academy to educate young people against fascism. Although they found a new and very respectful usage for the place, some of the buildings still feel somehow abandoned, as you can see, and the history can be felt almost everywhere. There was also this old abandoned tank on a military training area in the same region. I don't think it has much to do with the castle, but it was kinda cool, so I wanted to show it to you anyways. It could be some kind of HS-30 personal carrier, but honestly, I have no idea, so feel free to leave a comment below if you know what this is. However, I hope you liked this video and this small history lesson. If you did, please give the video a thumbs up and feel free to check out my other ones. See you soon!